Hey guys, Spencer from Buildapreneur here, and if you're like me, you are dying to find a good software that lets you do awesome lives and isn't insanely complicated. So we're going to take a look at my BeLive TV account and see why, after going through 5 or 6 different options, I settled on BeLive TV. Okay, so what I've done is I've logged into my BeLive account and I've clicked New Broadcast. And here's the screen that we get to. So we'll kind of talk about the different things that it can let you do and the different things that I like about it. Now, the first thing that I love is that it is browser-based. Okay, so as you can see here, it's all done in the Chrome browser. There's nothing that I download to my computer. And a lot of other live streaming softwares do go straight to your computer. And some people like that because they like not having to use these web-based browsers because they're afraid they'll crash or something like that. I promise you, I've used BeLive 15, 20 times now for lives and never once had a crash. It works really well. So anyway, what it's going to do is it's going to start by adding source. And the cool thing about BeLive is you can add as many sources as you want, meaning you can add multiple audio sources, multiple video sources, media files, all kinds of things. Let's just start by adding one source. You can see it's created the live now, and we'll tell you how to change all the visual stuff that you're seeing here. You select a source right here, and then it lets you choose what camera you want. Okay, so you can see I've selected a camera here. Now what you see here, and this is also what I love, is this is exactly on the screen what you're going to be seeing on the Facebook Live. Okay, so it's always showing you in this box right here exactly what your audience is seeing, which is good. I've had some that don't do that and I end up in like all kinds of peril as someone's like, hey, we see this on your screen or something, you know, and I'm like, crap, I didn't notice that. So this will be showing you exactly what your audience is seeing on their screen. Now, as you can see here, I added one source and it's here, but it's not on the screen. So it's very, very easy. You just throw it up there and boom, now we can see I'm on the screen. It's a little behind because my camera is also running this YouTube video. but then you can easily add other sources if you want. So you can see I can click here. It's added another camera and I can choose a different video source. So we can choose this web camera here. And you can see it's down here. It says, okay, we've added a new video source. And I can be doing this while I'm live, by the way. That's cool that we can do that while I'm live. It says, do you want to add it? Yeah, I can add it. Or you can see on this one, I can remove it. So I throw it in there. Now it just does that. Boom, we're ready to go. You've got two different sources. You guys are probably getting a headache because you're probably getting 3 or 4 different cameras of me talking. But you can see down here at the bottom, you can choose different layouts for how you want that to look. You know, I can choose interviewer and interviewee or switch it if it's the wrong interviewer or interviewee. So lots of different options here that you can do in terms of visual, and it shows you everything. You can also mute one or all of the people, okay? So I can say, hey, this guy is watching. I want him to be seen but not heard, so let's mute him. Now, another cool thing that I love is if you see here, it's got an ability to screen share. So it does the same thing. I can select a screen. We'll select this screen. We'll see even more of me. And now, once again, I've got a third source, and it's just all down here, okay? So it's really, really cool that just down here is everything that I want to be able to mess with that can go on the screen, and I can just throw it in and out, you know, at my will very, very easily. So I can toss in my screen share here, and now we've got 3 different sources. Maybe we drop this one, and we do something like that. Once again, you know, we can do all kinds of things where we can show the whole screen and show me, and whoop, there we go, the infinite loop. But lots and lots of potential with that. The other cool thing that I love is if you're having guests on your YouTube channel or your Facebook Lives, which a lot of us do, hopefully, is guests get similar access, okay? So previous platforms that I used have made it really hard for my guests to share their screen. Like, they don't even have the option, a lot of them. But this one gives the same, basically the guests are looking at the same thing that you're looking at, and so they can add screens, they can add different, you know, video sources, different audio sources. They have similar control about what they're broadcasting to you, which I really like, because I love for my guests to hop on and like say, like, yeah, let me show you my screen and I'll show you exactly what I'm talking about on my screen right here. Okay. Another cool little thing, and I'm gonna minus something before everyone head explode, is you can add different media sources. So I can add pictures and things like that, and those will show up down here. So I can say, hey, I want to upload a picture, and it'll pull up the picture right here, and you can add a picture of someone you're interviewing, or really all kinds of things, right, you can do with throwing in a different piece of media into your content there. Now, another thing that I really love is the options that are right down here. They're so cool, okay? One of the things I've hated about other platforms, I don't want to say names of other platforms here, But I've hated how complicated it is to do things like adding overlays, or how complicated it is to add templates or themes or background pictures, right? Like, they just kind of make it more complicated. But BeLive is just so simple to use. So you can see I've got all kinds of things going on in terms of text on screen. So you can add a title, and that's what's going to go right here. And that's just a title of your broadcast that you can have sit there the whole time. I'll show you later how you can choose kind of a theme or the general look of that title. My title is Spencer is really cool. And all you've got to do is click with the video or the eye icon, and you can see my title is sitting right there. That's the title of the broadcast. You can also add this little thing that scrolls across the bottom right here and control what's going on there. So you can say, like, what I like to do is tell people to engage, like, hey, as you hop on the live, I want you to do this and, you know, engage in my content. And it's very, very easy for me to do that. And then you get some engagement and people start showing up more on your live. You can also add an agenda, which is really, really helpful, and the agenda will show up. So if I click show on a different piece of my agenda, it'll replace the title, and it'll basically tell people where you're at in that, you know, in that live. Like, hey, we're interviewing this guy right now, or hey, this is a three-step training. We're on step number two, creating your blog or something like that, right? And then BeLive, so I like it because it's not like unlimited in the options to where it's really complicated and confusing in terms of like visual options, but it does give you enough options that you can really put your brand onto your Facebook Lives, okay? You can brand them with logos, and you can brand, you know, background images and one of those things that go above and below the videos, whatever those are called, overlays and all kinds of things like that. So you can see here, it doesn't have a lot of themes. They're quickly building this out, but that's all they have right now, and that's kind of a downer. They only have two themes. But you can choose colors from a palette, meaning you can choose basically what color this is going to be, and this is going to be, and the text is going to be, and it's going to create a theme for you based on that color palette that you select. So like I said, I don't love that. It's not like, you know, it doesn't give you a ton of options, but it is there, and you can visually brand it with your brand colors. Things that I do love are, let's go back to here. You can add a logo. So a logo up here. So I didn't add my logo. I don't know why. I just added a picture of a random house instead. But you can add a logo that then stays on your broadcast, gives you a little branding there. An overlay, which honestly an overlay gives you pretty much unlimited access to branding, right? You can add something at the top and the bottom that really brands to you. You could add a logo with a PNG file that sits, you know, right here if you want, and keeps it branded to you. It's really unlimited options to just really quickly create a PNG file that sits here as an overlay to your live, and there's lots of cool things that you can do with that concept. And then if you guys remember in the beginning, how I selected, here, I'll show you this. If I add this in here and I select this, there's now a background photo. So if I go to here, I can change and upload my own background photo to be whatever it is that I want to be, you know, something on brand, maybe more on brand than that mountain there. But as you can see here, it definitely gives you the option and the ability to easily create branded Facebook Lives without overcomplicating it. And that's kind of the theme of this review, is it's got a lot of options, but not so much that you're like blown away and it's just too complicated for it to use. It's very, very easy to use, very, very easy to control what's on your screen and what's not on your screen, and to see what's on your screen and what's not on your screen. Now, by the way, a little quick plug here. If you are a content creator, you're looking to grow your audience or monetize your audience online, please click subscribe down below. I put out lots of content that targets those two specific things, growing and monetizing an audience. So who wouldn't want to subscribe to that? Anyway, let's keep talking here. As you can see here, it's got a chat option right there on the right. And other ones have done this really bad. BeLive does it really, really well. Basically, as I'm doing my Facebook Live, people are putting out comments, and they will all show up in order right here so I can easily see and manage what's going on and respond to comments in the Facebook Live. Now, one caveat is some users, there's like all kinds of weird privacy issues. It's Facebook, right? Some users, it will just show Facebook user. It won't actually show who they are, who's making the comment. But a lot of users, depending on like how they do their settings, and if they allow it, will show their Facebook profile, and it'll show who's talking and things like that. So you can say like, oh, hey, Alan, thanks for joining. Here's an answer to your question, and we can go from there, right? And then it also has a private host chat where if you're interviewing, right? So like right now I'm interviewing myself. I can say, hey, Spencer, you know, I can privately say, hey, Spencer, you are talking far too much. You need to stop talking. Or, hey, can you cover this? Or so-and-so has a question about this, and they can kind of just see it'll pop up, and they can, you know, in the flow of the Facebook Live, still continue to answer that question. So very, very nice that it's got the private chat option and the group chat option. Something else I really liked was the ability to schedule. So when you're doing a Facebook Live, yeah, you want to just hop on and go live, but sometimes you want like people to know about it, right? You want them to know like a week in advance. So you can actually, right here, oh, I think I clicked the wrong button. Sorry. I can click here and I can change the title of my stream, the description of my stream, and then I can schedule my stream and say, hey, this is actually going to be in 3 days, this stream. And what that means is it's going to show up on my Facebook group or my page or whatever, and it's going to say, hey, Spencer's going live in 3 days. Do you want to get a reminder? And you can create this little event, right? And people get reminders. And then when you go live, it actually shows up, which is obviously very, very beneficial. So very, very easy to schedule a stream. And then all you've got to do is head over to here and you go to My Streams. And if you've got a scheduled stream there, it would show up right here and you would just click Open Broadcast Studio. Well, so the last thing I kind of want to talk about is this little button right here, downloading video, downloading audio. So if you're one of those content repurposers, which you should be, you do a Facebook Live and like it's valuable stuff, right? It's an interview or something. It's like 30 minutes of video that you just created. You don't want it just to sit on Facebook. You want to put it on YouTube and you want to like send it out to the world, right? So the option is here to download your video, download your audio, and then put it onto a podcast or put it onto a YouTube or all kinds of things that you can repurpose that content with. It automatically does that, so you don't have to do anything. It's just there for you, ready to go. So I think we've we understand the entire BeLive dashboard. As you can see, it's a very simple to use software. It's not at all hard to use, but powerful in what it can do. And like I said before, I've never had a live cut out when I use BeLive since they upgraded and did like some big changes, and you're looking at kind of the new interface and stuff. Since they've done those changes, it has been incredible and I'm just so happy with it. And that's why I'm happy to recommend it. There is a link down below. So if you want to sign up for BeLive, please use my link down below. I'm an affiliate of BeLive. Yes, that is an affiliate link. No, I don't promote any other products and don't just do it for the money. Now remember, if you want to create an audience or monetize an audience, don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching.